This space and this project comes out of a desire I had 3 years ago to do a show in Los Angeles. I hadn't done a show in like 10 years, like a real large painting show in Los Angeles, but I've lived here for 20 years. I went through a whole year of looking at very specific connotation type buildings like churches and theaters, and much smaller than the one we're in now. And through looking around Los Angeles, I just sort of found Boyle Heights and this incredibly grand space, untouched from, it was a lithography studio in the 40s, and then Liberace's piano storage at some point, and then just thought, instead of like responding so much to the space, this space would give me the opportunity not just to do a kind of straightforward painting show, but also something else I've been interested in for many years, which is like collaborate with other artists and people like Ooga Booga, who are in the front space. We did a collaboration called Fruits and Nuts. Everything was made here with the intention of being shown here, and I spent like the first month putting pieces of paper up on the wall and trying to figure out like the scale of the work and how, because I've been working on many projects recently in the last 5 years that all the paintings become one, and it's an exhibition and a painting at the same time, even though it's made out of multiple paintings. Mm-hmm. And so for this show, I really wanted to push the idea of like each individual painting being autonomous, or going towards that autonomous idea that painting inherently has. Look carefully, like it has like so many different spaces, like there's a bus on top of a gas station, and like a bike that's the size of a gas station, a policeman that's the size of a building, you know, like it just doesn't make any sense. They're not far enough apart that you feel like they're really unique experiences, because they're always in your periphery, but they're also not like jammed up against each other. This one I made like just a drawing on a piece of paper, which I projected. Then I figured I did it to scale, projected, and then remade the cats. And then after that, I took a picture of it, put it back in the computer. You know, used Photoshop to decide where am I going to put these colors, what colors is it going to be. If I'm trying to do something where I'm trying to communicate with people where we're working together, it's always easier to like try to show them, because it's such a large scale, in Photoshop or on the computer, or you know, printing it out and actually drawing with a colored pencil, like, well, this is what I'm trying to do, you know, so that like visually we're both on the same page.
Right.